kids, you never, ever go in the corners like this. He didn't mean to hit him. He was just finishing his check. This is a penalty here. Look how he goes in head first. He's just asking for it. I mean, I don't blame the guy. He just finished his check. He didn't mean to hit him in the head. You never go in the corner like that. You never, ever do it like that. You're just asking for it. And this is the old deal with the helmet on. Remember, Nick and I were talking. You'd have your head on a swivel. You'd never go in like that. Anyhow, that's a one shot.
You know, and it's not the only. I'm with you, Don. Two is okay by me. The other hit was Carlo got it early in the period. Sammy Blay lined him up and kind of got him in the numbers as well. But it's a bang bang play, and they're clearly.
Well, they're banging this. This is a playoff. Just a goal like this. They're trying to get back from last year or last game, and I see how he's got his head turned. Never do that, kids.
And
you're
too far
just
out.
Asking for it. All right. Let's go.
This is your favorite camera, the ankle camera, we call it.
Watch this here. This morning I'm sitting watching. Why are the Carpenters? Why are they taking the boards off? This is a little car, right? I think it's below Geico, I think it is here. This is a shot here. We got a little shot of here. See it there? Right below. That is a great camera. Remember C.V. Iserman?
Sure do.
Had the same thing in Detroit. Remember that great shot? The only place they had that shot was in Detroit. It was a great shot. Finally, they're doing a little bit, one at the other end, too.
One interesting thing, because poor Matt Grzelcyk's dad, John's Bull Gang, and so is his brother in the Bull Gang, who are the guys that do most of the work around the garden. But you said Carpenters did the...
Listen, the Carpenters, they wear overalls, white overalls, well, light brown overalls, to set themselves apart. The very first time, I think it was like in... I went there and I looked at the Boston Bruins when I was coaching. I saw nails. So I said, I got a hammer, and I'm hammering. I see these feet beside me, and all of a sudden he says, you can't do that. Union. They got the strongest union in the world around here. And I stood up and I said, who's going to stop me? But anyhow, that's the goal. That's the shot there. They have a union here. And the Carpenters really think they are something around here, but they strut around in the overalls.
And another thing you saw this morning was Robert Bortuzzo, who you're kind of in love with, getting ready. First guy.
Now, here's the first guy. He's out on the ice. He's ready. He's ready to go. And remember, he got the first goal. And he's also a relation to the toughest guy. We talked to Bob Plager this afternoon. Got the goal. And we talked. He's relation to Battleship Kelly. I think we're going to show a little shots of Bob Plager. Boy, was he a tough guy. There he is there taking shots. And there's Darren Pang before. And you know what he said? He said Battleship Kelly was the toughest guy ever in hockey. We got some great shots of Battleship. I know he's Thunder Bay. Look at that. And I remember the happiest day of my life, one of the happiest days of my life, is when Dennis Ball phoned. When I had the team in Rochester, I said, one guy I want, the first guy, was Battleship Kelly. And he listened to me. He went to the National Hockey League, got 30 goals. Boy, the toughest guy ever in hockey, Battleship Kelly.
And by the way, Bob Plager from Kirkland Lake, 100th anniversary, and we got the sweater, right? The Holy Name sweater. And we said, can we show that? And Bob's not a chance. And I was Legion. They were the bad guys.
Oh, but, yeah.
Wasn't that funny?
We won't say
so
what
Dick
else Duff, he
for
said.
For sure, you can't
boy,
tie that in with Bob.
Was he a tough guy, the Plagers and the Plager brothers, Billy and Barkley. Boy, they were a tough group. And he said, and he knows he bought them all, Gassoff with Gassoff.
Right, we were talking Battleship about Bob Kelly. Gassoff, and he said, tougher. All right, Chara's forearm gone, the cut.
Now, look, kids, you know, they're not going to change. They're not going to change the gloves. You blocked the shot. You saw the gold, the blood coming out. And the short gloves, look at that. And I know they're not going to change. But there is something, fathers and mothers, there is something you can buy in the stores that goes above the gloves that'll save that. You see him on the morning skate. He's got something over top of it that he won't get cut. I mean, isn't that ridiculous? And we got a great shot of Bobby Orr with the long gloves. And this is hockey. I know we got. This is hockey. You're going to see hockey at his best. Now, there he is in this morning skate. He's got felt over. It's not going to do any good, but it won't get out to cut like that. They're ridiculous. But there is a thing you buy. Now, there's Bobby Orr. Look at the gloves he has. He got ankle guards on there, too. Is that hockey?
It's totally.
Or is that hockey? Boy, hey, do you love that?
It's one of the great, the whole TD Garden is filled with great photos, but there's that Bobby
That's
Orr.
That's when he was a rookie.
1966-67. Okay, we're getting a little tight for time, but Brad Marchand, who's coming apart at the seams here tonight, was at least really focused in the final minute the other night.
Well, you know, he took control. He's throwing his stick around. He has something. He never iced the puck. See that? The last game, he never iced the puck, but he gets the goal anyhow. Smart enough, if he ices a puck, you know what happens there? There's a face-off at the end. And I think we have a great picture of Blue coming up, don't we?
Yeah, let's show you first in Springfield, because this is obviously where you had the Jack Adams Trophy glory years. But you also played in Massachusetts over in Springfield, and it kind of looks like Bobby Orr, the nice photograph at least. Wearing number five, alternate captain.
Who gave us that? Mike Emmerich gave us that.
Doc Emmerich brought this
now
in.
Now look at the big knees we got. We all had big knees back then. You're going to laugh when I say that. We had cotton batten in them. The Rocket Richard had it in the all. Not that I was Rocket Richard, but we all protected our knees that with cotton batten. And I didn't have my knees bent. And Brian Kilray, I never had my knees bent like you guys.
And Blue and you, here's a great shot of you with
now,
a
this
crocodile.
Is a team, this is a team. It's a great team. That's Blue and I. And I'll tell you the story. We were having a team picture in there. Look, she's looking at it. She loves Cash. Isn't she a Wayne Cashman? She loves Wayne Cashman. That was in the paper the next day. It had Bruins going to the dogs. I mean, look at all the players laughing. It was great. But honest to God, this is a true story. She come out, walked all the way around the gardens by herself, and come out to visiting teams and got on the ice and got the team picture. God, I love that dog.
Donald S. Cherry and Blue in the coach's corner on Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup playoffs.